Hi there. Welcome to Teachers Tech. My name is Jamie, and it's great to have you here. Today, I have a quick Microsoft Excel charting tip for you, and that's how to make your max number, or even your minimum number, stand out on your chart, and it will dynamically change as the numbers get updated. I really like using this quick method to make these charts much more interesting. Your eyes just go exactly where they need to go. So again, if this number right here, which is 95,000, turned into 595,000, and I just hit enter, you can see how it just dynamically changes. It found which one is the highest, and it really just shows that, and your eyes go right there. Okay, so I have a different sheet here, and I just have this data right here. And we're going to, first of all, just create a chart from our basic information that we have here, this. So I'm going to just highlight this and go up to Insert. I'm just going to go to Recommended Charts, and we're going to choose this first one right here. Now, I could go ahead and change the colors and different things. You can see the different options that you have. I'm just going to go pick this one for my demo purposes here and leave it right here. And you can see how I can move things around if I wanted to, drag it over here. Now, so what do I need to do now? I need to add another column beside the sales. And I already have it labeled max in this one. And I'm going to create a formula with a couple different functions in there. It's going to be an if and a max function. So to start my formula, I'm going to use the equal sign here. And it's going to be an if statement, an if one. So I'm going to put the if. So if what? So if this cell right here, and what do I want to happen is the max, so equals, and I'm going to start typing max now. So, and then you're going to see max as your options, choose max of what different, of what's the range that I wanted to check for max? Well, it's going to be this range right here. So B2 through B7, I need to make sure I use absolute values on these ones. So the references. So I'm just going to use on my keyboard, hit the function F4, and they all go at the dollar signs, or you could add the dollar signs individual. I'm going to go ahead and close that bracket and put a comma, because the next thing I'm going to say, so if is the max, I want it to return the value of whatever is in B2. Otherwise, I need it to return a blank. And so to do that, I just need a double quotation mark. So just like that, two quotation marks. Is going to put a blank back into that spot. So I'm just going to hit enter. Now, that this is the only spot I have done right now. So you can see here's the formula, nothing in here. I need to copy this down. So I'm just going to double click on this and it fills this out. Is this the highest amount of all these? Yes, it is. 580,000, 580,000. If this number changed, so if I took the 5 off of here, then it finds the new highest amount. Now this is updating, so that's the first step, but it's not showing that other, the column, it's not being indicated as nicely as in the, when I first started with the examples. So what I need to do, I'm gonna click on this right here. You can see where the chart data is coming from. I just need to expand this. So I'm gonna grab the corner and drag it over. And notice I have a new bar right here beside it, but I don't want that to happen. I want it just to be one bar. So if I go to this orange bar right here, and I'm just gonna right click, and I'm gonna go format the data series, and you're gonna see this open up on the side. I need to make sure where it says series overlap, this needs to be 100%, not negative anything, it needs to be 100%. So I'm gonna put 100 in there and just hit enter, and look at that. It's all one right now. So let's test this out here. So if I go ahead and say this, where this one is the 80, I'm gonna just go and put the number 4 in front of it. 480,000 should be the highest. Let's see. Yep, it adjusts. Now this is the 480,000. So it's that quick, you can make this just by adding that other column. But as I said, what happens if you wanted to show the minimum? Well, you can quickly change the formula here too. So let's say this is going to be the minimum and I'm just going to change this top part to min. I can go to this and just change this right through here. So there's a max and a min. I'm going to go to min, hit return. I'm going to copy this all the way down And notice this, it changed right away. So 70,000 is the lowest. So if I take this number right here and I put in 50,000 here, return, well, the clothing becomes the lowest. So 50,000, 50,000. So depending on which way you want to show this, you can change that from minimum, maximum, but it's a great way. Your dynamic charts are like this, and it just really gets the eyes looking on what you really want to show, and it just, your eyes are drawn towards that. So I hope you like this little tip in Microsoft Excel charts. Let me know what you think down below in the comments. Thanks for watching this time on Teachers Tech. I'll see you next week with more tech tips and tutorials.